In this example, we are given with a block B of mass 1 kg, which is attached to a spring of natural length 7 cm. And force constant 2000 Newton per meter, of which other end is attached to a fixed point A. We can see this in figure. It is given that initially the block B is placed at a position where the distance AB is 10 cm. We can see natural length is 7 cm and right now the spring length is 10 cm. That means, yes, extension in a spring is 3 cm. Now if block B is released, we are required to find the maximum speed attained by the block during its motion. Now in the solution, we just have a look very carefully that in the initial situation, the potential energy stored in the spring can be given as half k into 0.03 whole square. And obviously spring will exert a force kx, if x is the elongation, kx will be the force acting on the block. Due to the horizontal component of this kx, the block will move toward left. And we can see when the block will be in a position, when it is vertically below the point A, the length of a spring will be minimum. And this minimum length is 9 cm. That means at this stage also, the spring is elongated by 2 cm. But this is the position where a spring will have least potential energy. That means when it is being transferred from this position to this position, spring is doing work on the block, block is gaining kinetic energy, it will attain a speed, and speed will be maximum when it is vertically below A, because at this position, the potential energy of a spring will be minimum. So kinetic energy gained by the block will be maximum. So if we find out the potential energy of a spring in final position, that is when it is vertically below the point A, it can be written as half k into 0.02 whole square, because the extension is 2 cm. We need to use the data in meters. Now, if we use the work energy equation, you can simply write by work energy equation, we can write initial kinetic energy of block was 0. Spring has supplied energy. So whatever is the energy loss in the spring, that will be the work done by spring on the block. So we can write it half k into 0.03 whole square minus half k into 0.02 whole square. This is equals to half m v square, that is the final kinetic energy of the spring. Here this half gets cancelled out. Speed can be directly written as it is root of, you can take k common, it is k upon m multiplied by square of 3 is 9, square of 2 is 4, it is 9 minus 4, it is 5 into 10 to power minus 4. When we substitute the values of k and m, we can see k is 2000 newtons per meter and mass of block is 1 kilogram. This is root of 2000 divided by 1 into 5 into 10 to power minus 4. You can see here the result which is coming out at 1 meters per second. That is the answer to this problem. This is the maximum speed the block will attain, and it will happen when block will reach the position vertically below A. Because when it will move further, the spring will again gets elongated and energy stored in the spring will increase, and restoring force will apply an opposite force on the block, so speed will start decreasing. Indirectly, you can say the block will be oscillating to and fro about this position, and at this position, the speed of block will be maximum and its result is 1 meters per second.